Okay, started.
Hi everyone. Today we are just going to just take little bit idea about how our emotional and mental thinking works. Before starting, I'll just tell you about myself. I am Abhilasha Khare. My voice is coming to me. 1 minute.
Yeah, your voice is fine, Abhilasha.
Fine? Yeah, okay. So, I'm Abhilasha Khare from Gujarat, Vadodara, working for MNC, one of the oil and gas company, Linde Engineering. And same time, I'm practicing Sahaj Yoga meditation since last 20 years. And while meditating and while just practicing, I, you know, find it out so many things, which one of the things today I want to discuss, or I just want to share that thing. Here, I'm just sharing my screen here. Is everyone able to see it?
Yes, we can see.
Here, our topic is how to control the wheels of mind through Sahaj Yoga meditation. What the wheels of mind? Sometimes we are seeing our thinking is going so fast and so many bombardments of thoughts so fast, even we can't imagine that thing. So how it happens and why it happens? What is the thing which, you know, is coming so fast, the more than the light? So anyone, this is the open, forum today we are talking. Is anyone, can we tell me about what we think about the mind? What is mind? Hum general baat karte hain ki आपके माइंड में क्या चल रहा है?
थॉट्स.
थॉट्स. ग्रेट. एंड व्हाट इज दिस क्रिएशन ऑफ माइंड एंड इट्स एग्जिस्टेंस? व्हाट डज अवर माइंड चेंज टाइम टू टाइम एंड हाउ दिस माइंड प्लेज द रोल इन अवर डिसीजन मेकिंग इन अवर पर्सनालिटी मेकिंग? हाउ डू यू थिंक अबाउट? Okay, what is mind? Mind is thought. Got it. Now, creation of mind and its existence. How it happens? Why it's there? Is anyone? All are, working in day-to-day life. All day, so many things, so many thoughts come. Why this thought comes? Why we allow them to come? Anyone? As you said, what is mind? Mind is thought. What happens? When any child born, that time, and for any human being, there is no thoughts at all. That thought's mind is not there. Slowly, slowly, as the human being grows, as we grow, we start seeing we start listening, we start recognizing, and on these basis of this senses that one started, the things are recording in our brain, and through that we are playing the thought that it comes, this is mine, this is yours, this is my mother, this is my father, and it starts from there and it exists till today. This is my time, this is my system, this is, and these are the decisions I have to take. This is the thing which goes on. But anyone anytime thought about that to get rid from this?
Yes, I thought of getting rid of, because it creates a lot of confusion, a lot of imbalances.
Yeah, in our day-to-day life, we are seeing these things. When the mind changes, anyone? We are just talking normal. It's not like any research we are doing. The day-to-day life, these things.
Yeah, mind changes when we see something different from what we were thinking.
Mm-hmm.
You would have planned something and you would be doing some action, then suddenly some other things come into mind. Some other things we see and the mind changes that what we are doing is not correct and we change our track.
Okay. Correct. And that same thing comes to the role of mind decision making. Right? When any thought comes and we find it's not working and there is no truth about it, that the thought came to us and we decided this is the thing. With the mind, there is one more thing which we call brain. The brain is actually the truth which is there and always there. And the mind is the thought process, which comes through our, you know, daily basis conditionings coming since of our, with our birth time, not with birth, with the birth time it comes. Now, what is there in that? Mind runs on two wheels. If we say here, what are these two wheels? One thing we get with our, you know, conditioning or the, you know, with the starting that we have relationship, we have surrounding with our people. People told us something, don't do this, do this. And we made, this is the condition that it goes that way. That is one thing. It happens with everyone. Second thing, when we achieve something, when we say, yes, I have done it, we create one kind of authority on that work or that process. And that becomes our, you know, ego. It comes like, no, it's done it. We are not looking then the second side of this. So, it happens, these thought process work either through the ego, either through the conditioning. And how we, you know, reflect through this mind, through the reactions. There is one saying, the mind is like donkey. If we are behind the mind, you know, if the donkey is, we are behind the donkey, donkey will give us, you know, one back leg, hit with the back leg. If we are, if donkey is following us, then it will, or it will give us, you know, to just take our ears and take us, go here, go there, that way. What about if anyone rides on the donkey? if the animal is having the control on the donkey, then what happens? What happens? The person who is sitting on donkey, he can ride the donkey. That's the thing. Sometimes, time to time, we all have faced that we have thought, so if we are listening to mind so much, that is, there is no world of that, and we made the world of our thoughts, and we go so many questions and send answer, and we write the whole book on that. This happens, with everyone happens. And finally we come, whenever we get fail on our mind, or whenever our any job where the this thought process was applied, it gets failed, or we get failed, we say, actually mera dimag kharab ho gaya tha, ya mera mind kharab ho gaya tha. This is the common use sentence. Or if we go to success, if we reach any job or any successful action, then we say, mere mind ne socha, and that we recognized as ego. So those reactions comes, and that mind gets big, 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 and it overpowers our brain. Because of this overpowering of mind over brain, you must have seen we stopped using nowadays brain. Anyone tried or experienced this thing? So many things on the available on the computer, just copying and pasting, because everything is ready, we think. Right? Nowadays, on the net, there is no copyright. If having copyright, even we are copying the small or big thing. And we are developing this way that we are doing this job. It's available, it's milta hai sab. That mind is, we are making that way. So many things, so many times we are finding this thing, we are not using brain at all. There are many sayings of, you know, scientists, whoever works for the research, they have done some invention, they all say that they came out of the mind, then they found the things, and they just invented the few good things. How about your experience about it? Anyone can just tell me how you control your mind, or how you talk to your mind. Please reply me about this. What is your experience about mind? We are in the family with the kids, with the elders. Every day we are, you know, coming to with the taking with this mind. And sometimes we want to get rid from this. Anyone? Please unmute yourself.
Ma'am, by focusing on the problem, we can control.
By focusing on the problem, again, we are giving one thought to control it. Yeah, when solving the problem, not thinking, then it comes the experience. Okay, good. Even if the mind is more active, we found it. When any problem comes, when mind starts giving us the solutions, either from the past experiences or as when we take the responsibility that I am the doer, I'll do that. When we start coming to the one step to step, these mind processes start on. As I told you, the success and the failure of mind, it makes the wheel of mind. The stories of success and failure makes our mind, which is called conditioning, and our ego. When the brain is reality, what the mind, how we, look into this brain and mind. Why we are behind the kids? Do some brain exercise. Nowadays, but kids are also, in the beginning started indulging into the mind. But always we ask kids, every parent, to nourish your brain, and they are trying to bring so many things for the kids to nourish their brain. But we find that instead of nourishing the brain, mind gets nourished and makes so many conditions. It happens this, or the ego it makes. Are you agree or not on that? Is anyone agree on that?
Yes, I agree.
Yes, ma'am.
So how to go? Just as I said, if mind is donkey, it making us fool every time. So many thoughts are coming to us. It's a time-consuming thing. It's, sometimes we indulge into it. We are not able to see or even think the proper thing. It happens. So how to get rid from this? Are you able to see this screen? How to win over mind?
Yes, we can see Abhilasha.
Okay. Anyone, please? Being present, I have wrote my thing, watching your source of thought. Minimize reacting tendencies. You must have seen some people are not reacting at all. And we have saying that the people who are not reacting, they are absorbing everything. Means their thinking power is good, as they say. Now we will move, we will come to know that how, what is actually.
Not necessary always.
Pardon?
Not necessary always, the one who doesn't react of everything.
Yeah. That's what. Very good. Be it present. So many times when we are so much puzzled, people are telling us, just to leave it, be in present. So what is this present? This present, where there is no thought, is present. So anyone tried anytime, there is no thought. Chalo, let's, we will see this. Watching your source of thought, watching your source of thought. ये चीज तो हमारे साथ हुई है कि कई बार हम देखते हैं कि हमारे थॉट्स कहाँ से आए हैं. एनीवन वॉच दिस थिंग. वी आर आस्किंग सो मेनी टाइम्स फ्रॉम वेयर यू आर सीइंग दिस प्रॉब्लम फ्रॉम द बुक्स. ओके मूवीज या from discussions, yes. And these movies, any discussion, these all things are making our mind. So we have to think again how to come to be present. Or stop that source of thought. We'll see next. One of the scientists, Einstein. Explain that whenever it's required to for any work, or the Einstein's research, he said he come to the particular concept when he went to the physical vacuum state. What is physical vacuum state? Physical vacuum state is where there is no thought. This is present, be in present. So today we have to learn, we have learned everything about the mind. Now we'll go how to control this mind, or how to put the brake on these conditioning which gives us thought, or how to give this ego to be down, to understand that next so many other things are available. One thing, be in present means going beyond the mind. There is one state, that is go beyond the mind. Beyond the mind, there will be no thought. That is a simple technique of Sahaj Yoga, which is given by Dr. Shri Mataji Nirmala Devi, who she's worked so many countries, almost more than 100 countries she worked, and various countries given her the award. She recognized in countries like Italy, America, Russia, and other Russia states like Romania, China, India, UK. In all these countries, She's given the honor and recognized by various positions. And there are so many testimonials and research work done globally on this topic. You can just know more about it from the website, that is sahajyoga.org. And one good website I'll give you, the wemeditate.com. So before experiencing this go beyond the mind, we'll just watch one small video and then we'll just experience this and try this, how it works. So I'm just sharing my other screen. Is everyone able to see it?
Yes, we can see.
Thank you. One minute again. Volume is coming there. Voice is coming.
No.
No. Now I'm playing. Just let me know. It's coming.
No, we can't hear the sound.
Okay, 1 minute.
Yeah.
Great.
We have two horrible tendencies. It is very easy to understand for Sahajyogis that we are the ones who react. Everything that is outside. The reason is we have two horrible tendencies, one which is the ego, and another tendency is that we are being trained that, or we can call it the superego or the conditionings. So both the things, our ego and conditionings, are all the time acting out. This reaction, which is built in within us, is just like bubbles in the ocean. And these bubbles keep us away from reality. These bubbles are of thought, and they just blast you all the time in your head, and you don't know why they are. When you depend on this artificial mind of yours, then you have no discretion as to understand what is good and what is bad. This mind is the one where all kinds of evil things start, all kinds of quarrels, fights, and possessiveness. Lastly, the war also comes there. It is in this mind only, which is nothing but a myth, all these concrete destructive ideas somehow or other come up, and then they start growing and growing. Then you find people whom you can impress also put ideas into their heads by reading they learn, or by their lectures, or by mesmerism, whatever kinds of things they can do, they put your mind into such a frame that you accept these destructive ideas for yourself individually or maybe for the collective. So this mind is just a myth, and we are working through this mind. We scientists, say Einstein has said that I was tired trying to find out the theory of relativity, very tired. He had some concept, like all scientists take up some sort of a concept and they try to build up their research on that. And then I thought it's a wrong concept that I do. Suddenly he said, I went into the garden, I said, let's try and play with the soap bubbles. He was playing with the soap bubbles like a small child. And suddenly from somewhere unknown, he said, the theory of relativity dawned upon me. Many scientists have said that they don't know from where they get this idea. From where did they get it? It has a special study now people are doing to find out how these scientists got these things. And in a very sahaj manner, even the way penicillin was discovered or anything was discovered by these people was not through the probing or manipulation of the mind, but through some unknown force it came into their mind, and that's what they thought, that this was from their mind. Some, but most of them realized, even Newton realized, that it is coming from something, some source which I am not aware of. As Sahajyogis, you know, it is the source of the divine power which is all pervading the Param Chaitanya. You know, because you can feel it, you know it is there. But even when you know, you must know you have to go beyond your mind into thoughtless awareness minimum. Always I tell you, meditate, meditate, because you should be in thoughtless awareness where you do not react. So what happens? You become a witness. You become the witness of the whole drama, of the whole scene, and you are absolutely at ease with yourself, no problem. And what you are doing, that you become an instrument of this Parama Chaitanya, of this All-Pervading. You are just watching, you are a witness, and as watching everything, you realize that whatever you are cannot react on you. But you know what it is. And this is what is the state in which you understand the reality of the whole situation. When you are in that state that you can give realizations to others, you can put them in connection with the Divine Power. But first of all, you must know how to become thoughtlessly aware. You have to go beyond this mind. And to go beyond this mind, the most helpful thing is Kundalini awake. Because she passes through your limbic area, pierces through your fontanelle bone area, and just takes you away, out, into the realm of reality. And the yoga takes place between your brain, I should say, your heart, with this all-pervading power. She's the one which connects. She's the one who does it. Many people are doing Sahajyoga, I know that. But it's difficult for them sometimes to get to meditation, to establish this thoughtless awareness, which is an extremely important state which you all should achieve. So many Sahajyogis are there, and I'm happy to know that they are getting deeper and deeper. But as long as they are in the turmoil of their mind, they cannot focus. Now once your attention goes beyond the mind, only the Sahajyogis you'll understand this point very clear. When this mind goes beyond the thoughts, then the manipulation of the attention is very important. Then whatever you manipulate means you take this attention to this or to that or to that. You will be surprised how dynamic you become, how effective you become, and how knowledgeable you become. Because once you can take this attention to anything you want, immediately there is light on that issue, on that person, on that problem, and you see how it works, how it helps. Sat Yogi in Sanskrit is very good at tatast. Very good word, which I'll try to explain but cannot be really translated. Tatastha means the one who is standing on the shore. On the shore and watch.
Hi everyone. Here we have seen, and this is something, go beyond the mind. How to go beyond the mind? There is a power within us. In our last session, everyone was here. That time we will actually need to repeat the same process, otherwise we just jump to go beyond the mind. There was the last session about the Sahaj Yoga last month. Everyone was there here that time? Okay. So what we have to do here? Go beyond the mind, that we'll go to our process. To the experience of this process. What happened? This is the one screen you must be seeing here. The one head of one boy is given over here, and 6 and 7 is written over here. This 6 and 7, this is the sixth, this is one kind of one chakra, that is one bundle of nerves in our brain, that is called in Sanskrit language chakra, that is called Ajna chakra. What happens? Because of our conditions, because of our egoistical behavior, I-ness, I can do it, and condition, things goes this way and it will happen this way. These are the conditions. When these things, two things is there, it creates one, two balloons over here in our brain. And these balloons are riding us throughout the life. And the whole countries, whole, you know, nations of the nations are running over only these two things. But go beyond the mind, when we will go about these thinking, you will see the things go totally different. So we will try it now. I'll just follow me. I'll just take some steps again and we will see. So I'm just minimizing this over here, stopping the share, and we will just do some exercise and see how we are going. Everyone is ready for that? Let's do that exercise. Yeah, a small meditation kind of thing. So what we'll do, same thing. Again, we'll close our eyes. We'll keep our right hand to our heart. Right hand to our heart. And then we'll keep our, again, right hand after that to our forehead. And third step, we'll keep our right hand to our fontanel bone area, this limbic area. This is the place where when we were child, that the small, the soft area. We keep our hand over here and rotate it in clockwise direction. These are the steps, 3 steps we have to do. First, we have to keep our hand, right hand on our heart. Second will be we have to keep our hand on our forehead, and third will be on the top of our head. Okay, so everyone is ready. You can switch on your cameras if you like, or it's okay, no problem. So initially we'll start with, we'll keep our both the hand towards, if you are sitting on the chair, take towards the Mother Earth. Just put your both the hand towards the Mother Earth and close your eyes. As Mother Earth giving us shelter, we are all, everyone is on Mother Earth. She is just giving us the roots. We can pray here. Oh Mother Earth, let all our conditionings, all our ego, sucked by the Mother Earth. This is very effective prayer. Because in last session, we had the Kundalini awakening. So we are continuing in that. Oh Mother Earth, please suck all my thoughts, just keep our eyes closed, our attention on our top of our head, the limbic area. Now we'll be both the hand on our lap, we'll take our right hand to our heart, where our spirit resides. Yes, dil hamara sahi kehta hai, and brain is truth, mind is myth. So yes, heart is our dil, not man. We'll say here, I am the pure spirit. I'm not this mind. I'm not this ego. I'm not the thoughts. I am the pure spirit. By God's grace, I am the pure spirit. I am not this party. I am not this mind. Now our second step, we will bring our right hand to our forehead. We just bend our head and put our right hand on our forehead and press little hard from both the sides, both the temples. And we'll say here, I forgive my thoughts. I forgive my thoughts. Here, there is a one mantra, or we say one residing here. It's called Hum Shum. Hum Shum. Hum means my spirit, this exists, it works, it acts. Hum, shum. Shum means I forgive my thought. I forgive my condition. My spirit is truth. My brain is truth. Hum, shum. Hum, shum. Hum, shum. Now we'll take our hand on our fountainal bone area, we'll keep our hand over here, stretch our palm, and just rotate the palm on our scalp in clockwise direction. And just recite in the heart, O Mother Kundalini, please take us beyond the mind. O Mother, please establish us in spotless awareness, or make thoughtlessly aware. Mother, please establish me in thoughtless awareness. Or, hey Mother Kundalini, please mujhe nirvicharita dijiye. Please connect my heart, my brain to the all pervading power. Take me beyond the mind. Slowly take your hand down and keep your eyes closed and try to sit quiet. Just keep an eye on our fountainal bone area, that some sensation and something happens, takes us beyond the thoughts. I forgive all my thoughts. If thoughts come in, say, I forgive. I forgive. I forgive. Just we'll thank to our spirit, we'll thank to ourselves. So everyone can let me know, was there any thoughtlessness there? Yes.
Yeah, when you work whole day and you do a lot of stuff, there's a lot of chaos, you know, and yeah. Now you feel a little more settled down and more peaceful.
Good. Jyoti, Nita, is there experience?
Yes, quite a lot of experience in terms of thoughts settling down and no more confusions.
Yeah, that is the magic in Sahaja Yoga, and that is the Kundalini. That is our own energy system. It works for us. So whenever we are having any doubts, anything comes on our way in business, in our profession, in day-to-day life, this is the one mantra. And it not comes in one day. We need to practice on it. Means if we go for daily 5 minutes, that's what we have done, 5 minute job. That 5 minutes, if you do at home, regular basis, you will find that lots of change in our day-to-day work and professional life. That I'm experiencing. And the same thing, we are just taking the sessions, we are just giving the kids also, the small kids, the same principle applies to everyone. And when kids are doing this thing, their studies goes very well. When we are in our profession goes very well. It's not required to do so much planning, so much things. It's only required to be attentive. How we go attentive and thoughtless when we are meditating, when this is in our practice. So it's required to practice every day, 5 minutes. So many more things in Sahaj Yoga, time to time, whenever we get the chance, I will be available. Thank you very much. If anyone has anything to ask, please let me know. Everyone is settled thoughtlessly.
Abhilasha, do you have anything where if in case, then don't get time to come in the morning meditation, like that we can do at our own times, like many professions?
There is one site I'll just share with you here. One is I share over here, wemeditate.com. This is the one very good site. If you don't get time to, available in the morning, anytime the site is available. And this is one online, app is there on Google App Store. You will find. If it is fine, you have that link.
Yes.
I'll do that. This is the one app we can just get in this app in our mobile, and whenever we want, in our comfortable time, day, night, whenever, we can use that. I'm just putting in a chat box. Yeah, this is the one on chat box. I have just given this. We can download in our laptop, mobile, and practice it whenever we want. And there are some, if any doubts, anything, it can be seen over there also. So this was my presentation, and hope I'm able to bring that thoughtlessness or that, awareness that how the Sahaj Yoga meditation helps us and how we enjoy really our own energy in the form of peace, joy, bliss, everything. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Abhilasha. One more session of, Sahaj Yoga. Last time also, I got, some sort of a white light.
Oh, good.
Last time I remember. Now, today also, we could have peace of mind. And I think meditation is definitely a source of happiness.
Yeah.
So I thank you very much for making this presentation. And I also thank every participant. Next week we have on 20th Tuesday, we have Mr. Nikhil Dani making.
You are on pause.
Sir.
Sir, you are on mute. We can't hear you.
Okay. Now, can you hear me?
Yes.
So, yes. All are requested to become a paid members because IA3 has got expenses. So, please, to meet these expenses, please become a paid member.
Sure.
Now, we invite people to conduct a knowledge sharing session. I'm happy to say that on the 18th of May, we will be completing 1 year. So on 25th, we will be starting our second year. So there are about 29 people who have conducted knowledge sharing session. So we are happy about this event that is taking place. So we are inviting articles for the e-journal of April 21. Those who wish to send article, please send it as fast as possible because Jyoti is waiting for these articles. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Abhilasha. Should I close it?
Yeah. Thank you.